All right, so I just seen that Beyonce showed up to that Kamala Harris. Well, I seen that like a week ago, that she showed up to that Kamala Harris rally, and she was only there a few minutes, didn't dance or nothing. Now you got J-Lo coming out speaking, you know, supporting Kamala Harris. It's funny to me. Epstein got arrested. And he supposedly ended himself. Then Maxine, I can't pronounce her name, his girlfriend. She got convicted of a crime, but they never convicted anybody else. Now you got the whole P. Diddy thing. You got Kamala Harris, who couldn't get one vote in the primary in 2020 when she was running against Biden to be the nominee. Couldn't get one vote. Most unlike candidate possible. And now all these people are coming out and supporting him. They did a coup against Biden. They just put her in. Didn't ask if anybody wanted her, any Democrat supporters in that. When they found out that nobody wanted her, she was tanking. Now, all of a sudden, all these musicians, these sports players, these actors and actresses, they're all coming out supporting Kamala. But they all got one thing in common. They all are known to hang around P. Diddy. And they haven't indicted anybody other than P. Diddy. Wonder why. Do what we tell you, support our candidate, or else. I mean, that's kind of seems how our Department of Justice has been working for many, many, many years. But yet these people go up on a stage and preach to you about morality. They call you garbage. Telling black people that they ain't black if they don't vote for this one or that one. But yet, these are the people that... And President Trump is going to come after his opponents and lock them up. He's going to lock up U.S. citizens and this and that. But they're the ones that use the Department of Justice to go after Donald Trump. When he was in for 4 years, I don't remember him ever having any of his opponents that ran against him arrested, investigated, or nothing else. The Epstein client list needs to come out. The Diddy freak-off tapes need to come out. There needs to be some kind of investigation into why these things aren't coming out. And that's never going to happen if anybody from this current administration is running things. I don't know if it would come out even if they weren't running things, but it definitely ain't going to if they are running things. This party right now talks about being the people of moralities and the people of respect and this and that. They talk about being unifiers, as they call half the country garbage. People wake up. They're trying to use. They couldn't get black people to vote. So they bring out, you know, people like Beyonce and that, trying to get black people to vote. White people aren't supporting them. So they bring out people like George Clooney and stuff like that to tell you that you're dumb. And you can't think for yourself in how to vote. Well, I work around all different kinds of people. Black people, Asian people, Arab people. And I'd say most of them are smart enough to think for themselves. They don't need other people, rich people that can't identify, can't even understand what these people go through every day, struggling just to get by. They could never understand it, but yet They're going to tell you what's best for you. They have no clue what's best for you. These ushers and all these other people, they don't live in ghettos. They don't live paycheck to paycheck. They don't understand you. They're never going to understand you. George Clooney, Jennifer Lopez, none of them are struggling to put gas in the gas tank. None of them are struggling to put food on the table. None of them are struggling to buy medications as they get older that they need. None of them are struggling with anything other than getting exposed for possibly being at P. Diddy parties and freak-off tapes. No matter how rich you are, how poor you are, the one thing that makes us all equal is your vote. It doesn't matter if a man has $1 billion, he gets one vote. And his one vote is not worth any more than the homeless guy on the side of the road vote. It's the only time you're equal. And if me personally, I'm tired of rich people telling me how I should think, how I should feel, and how I should vote. I'm going to vote for whoever I want to, and I don't care what they say. And I encourage everybody to do the same. Go out and vote. And vote for who's going to make your life better for the next 4 years. I can tell you, in my opinion, the people that are currently in haven't made my life better in the last 4 years. And that's all I got for today, everybody. Have a good day.